What's up, everybody, and welcome to today's video. In today's video, I have a beautiful crack-a-rack in here. This is a brand new addition to my collection. It is the newer version of the orange crack-a-rackin. This is the crack-a-rackin V2.5, as you can tell by the side milling right there. Beautiful. I really, really like this thing. Also, it's an inked, custom inked crack-a-rackin V2.5. So this is actually put together with the different hardware and made into a beautiful orange and black aesthetic that I really, really love. And it's the Bowie profile, which is my personal favorite. I traded this from a person called Vink Flips. You can see it right here. Boom, I traded that. That's mine. So yeah, Vink Flips, thank you very much. This thing is really awesome. But in the meantime, I wanted to talk a little bit about this thing and something that has been on my mind a bit recently and something that I think would be very helpful for you to know about. You see, this is kind of a follow-up to my bandage video. If you remember, I have a video where I talk about different kinds of bandages that you can use, and specifically I talk about hydrocolloid bandages. And so I've already given myself a little nick with this guy on my finger right here, and you can see that I've already bandaged it up, but with a very, very tiny little bandage. Where did I get that bandage from? Well, it is a Ral Beauty Miracle Patch. Wow. And believe me, when they say miracle patches, they mean it, because these are the best things for small balisong cuts and stuff like that. One of the things with balisong, right, is that when you're actually flipping, 90% of the time, most of the cuts you're going to get are going to be very small. They're either going to be pricks from the tip of the blade, or they're going to be small cuts across your hands in different ways, but very rarely are you going to be getting large cuts. Now, when you do get these large cuts, obviously you should have the bandages to deal with that, but what about these small cuts? You know, it feels kind of wrong to be bandaging up all these cuts when you're getting like really tiny nicks and scratches, you know, so what do you do? Well, originally I was using the hydrocolloid bandages, which work fantastically, but a full finger hydrocolloid bandage still is huge on your finger, right? Like it still wraps around your entire finger. And so they work great, but there's still a lot when you're only dealing with tiny cuts like this one. And so that is where these miracle patches come in. So the Ral Beauty miracle patches here, they're invisible spot covers. These are made for acne. Okay, and they do a really good job. Like if you have acne on your face and then you use a the spot cover or whatever, it'll do a great job of taking care of that. However, what I use them for is for tiny cuts from when I'm flipping. And the reason that they are so good for this is because they're literally just micro hydrocolloid bandages. So the active ingredient is hydrocolloid, so they're really just a hydrocolloid bandage, but really tiny. And I tested a bunch of different ones off of Amazon, and these Ral Beauty Miracle Patches happen to be the ones that work the best. And there's a couple reasons for that, but the main reason is that they stick really well to your finger. And so, as you can see, I am flipping pretty intensely with this on, and it stayed perfectly on my finger. And I think that's pretty important. So that's kind of a big deal for me in terms of like when I'm playing around with my balisongs and stuff, the patches have to stay on my finger. Now, something to note here is that these will not work super well if you have a cut that is fresh and like bleeding profusely. Hydrocolloid bandages are awesome, but they're mainly made to help heal a cut rather than to stop bleeding. And so if you have a cut that freshly started, the first thing that you want to do is just grab it and press on it like this. So whenever I get a cut, the first thing I did, like when I got this one, I felt it happen and I knew that I had a cut, and I immediately just took my thumb and pushed it onto the spot and held it there. And that was just to stop the bleeding as much as possible. Okay, you want to apply pressure to whatever wound you have, because that will, you know, keep the bleeding down very, very quickly. Then once you've gotten that, you know, if you don't see any blood coming out after you've held it for around 30 seconds, if not longer, then you can apply a miracle patch directly to the wound. And what's interesting here is that, so I can actually take this off right now. This one's like, this is kind of an older wound, so it's not really fresh. It's not really bleeding. It just looks a little gruesome, but it's not actually bad. I can apply a new miracle patch to it. And this is something that essentially you want to leave the miracle patches on. You don't want to peel them off like I just did. You want to leave them on as long as it takes for it to heal or until the patch falls off. But you can see I can just take this patch and put it right on top there. And then I just press it down and hold it there for a bit, and that really helps it adhere to the skin, okay? And what's so nice about this is that hydrocolloid basically automatically adheres with your skin, and it does so very, very, like, nicely and very, very intensely. You just need to apply pressure to it. And it might start to kind of peel around the edges after a while. Just reapply pressure and hold it down for a little bit, and usually that'll fix the problem. So, yeah, and yeah, look, it basically vanishes onto your skin. Like, it's so subtle. And what's nice about that is not only does it look better, like, it doesn't look like you've got your entire finger bandaged just because of this tiny cut. Now you've just got a little spot stuck onto it. But it really doesn't impact your flipping much. Like, I can still do a chaplain very, very, very easily. And it's going right over this spot where I got cut. Right? And that's super awesome. A couple other things to know about hydrocolloid is essentially it's simulating the inside of your body on the outside of your body, which allows your body to take care of scarring and tissue a lot more efficiently than it could if it was just, you know, an open scar. And so what it's allowing your body to do is it's allowing it to repair itself as though it was inside, and it'll remove stuff like scarring and it'll fix different issues like that. So yeah, it's pretty cool. And it's a natural antiseptic, it's a natural antiseptic, but it's also a natural pain reliever, because once your body starts to believe that this is inside of you instead of outside of you, the pain almost instantly becomes more of a dull pain than it does a sharp pain, because inside of you things hurt less than outside of you things, if that makes sense. And so, yeah, it also relieves pain without any, like, chemical pain relievers, which is pretty cool. So yeah, hydrocolloid bandages are awesome, and the way that these miracle patches work is that they come in a pack like this, which has a bunch of ones inside of it, and then, oh no, I made a mess. Inside of there, you get all of these, and these are the different sizes of miracle patch. So there are two main sizes for you to be aware of inside of here. You have the bigger 12 millimeter size and then the smaller 10 millimeter size. So for my finger here, I used the little 10 millimeter ones, and they're awesome. And you can see that that's still holding onto my finger pretty much perfectly. You just have to press down on it every once in a while just to make sure that it keeps adhering. But yeah, these are the 10 millimeter ones, nice and tiny. And so that's what's up here. And then when you go deeper in, you'll find these, which are the 12 millimeter ones. And these are relatively large, you know, so compared to the 10 millimeter ones, they're a bit larger and they do a better job of covering a larger area. So with the 12 millimeter ones, the spot on the inside where the, like, most hydrocolloid is larger than it is on the 10 millimeter ones. And so if you can't cover it with a 12 millimeter one, then it's probably time to get out the full hydrocolloid bandage and get yourself fixed up with that. But yeah, in terms of a flipper's arsenal, these have legitimately become the most useful thing that I have, and I keep them around all the time because, like, oh my god, do these, like, make everything better. It's insane. So yeah, that's how I've been fixing small cuts and scratches and stuff like that on my hands, is just these little acne patches, essentially. But they do a fantastic job of covering them up and, you know, keeping you healthy while still allowing you to flip, very fluidly and naturally. And, yeah, I really, really like them. I wanted to say thank you guys for waiting for such a long time. I went on vacation, and that was nice, but then when I got home from vacation, I ended up getting COVID, and so I was, like, laying in bed for the past few days, and I still technically kind of have COVID right now, but I'm just feeling a lot better. I'm in the downswing for sure, but you might be able to still kind of hear it in my voice that my voice is a little cracked up, not perfect, but I am feeling a lot better. So yeah, that was quite a vacation experience. I had a really good time, but getting COVID at the end always sucks. So yeah. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this one. Once again, this thing is awesome. I've really been loving the Cracker Acne V2.5, and I love the black and orange aesthetic. Like, this is so sick. And yeah, that's pretty much it for this one. Thank you guys for watching. Definitely check out the RAL Miracle Patches. Those are down in the description. There's a link to buy them. There's also a link to the like full-size hydrocolloid bandages for your fingers. But these are a must-have for any flipper, 100%. Like, they are seriously the best thing I've ever gotten. So yeah, that's pretty much it for this one. Anyways, thank you guys for watching. And yeah, peace. Boom.